Father, we thank you for this section of the Spirit. We give you praise and we give you glory because you are so faithful, Lord, to us. Thank you, Jehovah God, for yet another year that we have gathered again. Lord, it looks like yesterday, but here we are today. And this is how it will be again next year. Lord, just like that. But we are so bold tonight that, Lord, you will give us understanding of these things. And we will run with it. Amen. Thank you, blessed Lord. Honor your word tonight. And bless your people. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Put your hands together for Jesus. We are all seated away. You said that you need to sit down. Amen. Praise God. I want to appreciate God's servants. Thank God for their lives and the strength that is on the inside of them. And how they've been consistent over the years. We celebrate you and honor you, Pastor Rhoda, Pastor Emmanuel. Can we stand to our feet and give them honor? Can you do it better? Some of you are we are so proud of what God is using us to do. We celebrate you. And we know it can only get better. I don't have any doubts. Because it is empty in the nature of God for us to go back home. So it can only get better. God will keep taking you out of our lives. Amen and amen. Thank you for the privilege of standing here. Lord, lifting up your head in the name of Jesus. I celebrate everybody. Dr. Mo, God bless you. You gave us a strange message today. It's awesome. Can we celebrate her? Everybody that has held the microphone in great time of the other, it's awesome. Lord bless and honor you, all the pastors, all the ministers. Thank God for your life. Now let's quickly go and do what we need to do in a few minutes because I know everybody is so tired. Amen. But just don't let the Holy Ghost pass you by. So I want you to give me your attention. The word balance, of course, they have defined it to us in different ways. And I want to take it tonight as the ability to be steady, maintain steadiness, so that we don't fall. I want you to look at that definition that I've given it. It's the ability to maintain steadiness so that we don't fall. Another thing that God gave me that we want to address again, when you talk about balance is also calmness of mind. The ability to exercise or to have what we call emotional stability. Emotional stability. So these are the two things I'm going to be looking at as I'm talking to us this evening. And from there, we will do whatever God wants us to do. Now, with all the things that has been said since Friday, make me to come and challenge somebody that is here today. That there is a lot of things that God is expecting from us as believers. If there's anything I came to do today is to trigger fire out of you. To make you become what God really designed us to be. We cannot continue to be escorts watching things happen. If we say we want to really live in accordance with what God wants us to. I believe that the passion of Pastor Rhoda is for us to live out our beauty, bring out the beauty in the inside of us out, and not be a people that will be a Mary in the church and a Jezebel at home. I believe that is our passion when it comes to divinely balanced. And the two scriptures you used, the scripture of the one in Peter and the one in Matthew chapter 23. So I believe that is a heart cry. Now, taking it in that line, Isaiah 60 verse 1, very common scripture that I'm using to talk to us today. It's a common thing we say, arise and shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people. For the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen in you. But I love the Amplified translations that says, arise from the depression and frustration in which circumstances have kept you. Rise to a new life. Amplified Classic. This is Amplified Classic. And it says, shine, be radiant with the glory of the Lord. For your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, dense darkness the people, but the Lord shall arise upon you. The Message translations have something else to say. It says, put your light in the direction of the sunlight. And stop. He said, wake up, wake up, wake up. That was what the Message translation said. Now that makes me, Pastor Shola was talking yesterday, that makes me to key in from there to let you know that we are in a world that is full of darkness. We cannot deceive ourselves. Do you understand what I'm saying? A lot of things are happening today. I tend to challenge everybody. Now the law that they said they have passed now, it's part of the darkness on ground. Because there is no doubt that this law is going to affect the church. It's going to affect Christendom. But now God is telling you that darkness is in the world, gross darkness, the people, and is expecting you to shine out. Am I making sense to you here? Yeah. That despite the darkness, Pastor Shalom was talking yesterday and said, you speak out light. Because you have the power within you to speak it out. Because God created us in his image, and so we must speak it out. Because it took God to speak before darkness receded upon the heart. And so if darkness is going to give way, some people must stand up. If you don't stand up, darkness remains. I'm going somewhere. I didn't come to preach here. I came to deliver God's message to you. So don't think, and that's why I know that I'm not going to take much of your time, because I came to deliver specific message to somebody here. In Revelation chapter 5 and verse number 10, the Bible says, God has made us kings and priests unto him, and we are mandated. It is a mandate. We are commanded to reign on the earth, not to be subdued, not to be ruled over, not to be enslaved, but to maintain balance and reign upon the earth. Am I making sense to you here? So look at your neighbor's table, go and tell every person and announce to them, I want to reign and I will reign on this earth. I want you to stand up. Please make sure you obey every instruction I give from this altar today. I want to reign and I want to reign. Are you following me here? That is a mandate that God made us kings and priests. We are talking about the priesthood, and then we are talking about the throne when it comes to reigning as a king on earth. And then God said, you are to reign. If you reign, you reign in terms of sitting upon your position as a king in authority, and also as a priest with the word of God from your mouth. These are the two combinations that God expects us to use together to make us to reign and to rule upon the earth. It's a mandate. Not everybody is doing it, but that is the mandate of God for human beings, particularly believers that know Jesus. Praise God. Now, let's go on. Let's go on. Let's go on. May God help us this afternoon. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I was reading this time, this prayer, our Lord's prayer. And that also showed me what God expected us to do on the earth. Say, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Is that how he says it? And then thy will be done. So ladies and gentlemen, I discovered also that one of the things that God is expecting from us is for his will to be done on earth, and for us to bring his kingdom upon the earth. And then you cannot reign without bringing his kingdom upon the earth. I'm taking you somewhere. So it takes us to bring the kingdom of God upon the earth. In the book of Revelation, it says, and the kingdom of this world will become the kingdom of our God. And it takes some people to enforce that kingdom. And the same people that are to enforce the kingdom has already been given the mandate. Now, listen to me. And the mandate does not come without the authority. For your mandate to be established, there's an authority that has been given already. And so many times, what the devil does is to make us not to align to live the kind of life that will make us to exercise that authority to reign on the heart. Am I making sense to you?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go. Now, why did I make mention of that law? As you know, that in recent time, I've been talking to believers. And I've been telling them that, listen, if we want to change laws, we can't sit down. If we want to enforce law, if we want things to work in line with what God wants, it's not going to happen by magic. Hello? We can stay and pray from morning to night. The authority of the land is in some people's hands. Follow me here. Please, give me your attention. I came to wake up something in the inside of you. I came to let you know how God is waiting for you and you are disappointing you. I came to make us to know that we are being too religious, that what belongs to us is being taken away from us. It does not matter where you are living, whether this is your nation. The issue is the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. And wherever we are, we have to take dominion over that place. Am I making sense to you? Yeah. Okay, some people stay in parliament and they issue a law. And the law is affecting you. And now all of you are crying out, I want to start praying. Pray for what? That what God may help them to change the law. What of if we ask people that are represented there, who are also believers, so that before they initiated, am I talking to you here? Yeah, the law, the idea, and they fought it out before it is signed into a law. But believers are sitting down wishing for money tonight. They sit in their corner, hello, and they are looking fine, like they've been preaching since Monday, but they leave the place that God expects us to be. That is the place of rulership and reigning. And we left it for the other side. I'm trying to be careful because I know this, let me go. I discovered that in UK now, check all your, what do you call them? Is it mayors or whatever? What do you call them? No. Is it ministers? MPs. Check them. So many things we get back at home, it's all over the place. And see how many people that are there that are on the other side of the religion. Am I making sense to you?
Yes.
How many born-again Christians are there? How many? How many? We may not know them. Some are there. They are just religious Christians. Now, those people are gathering to make what will govern your life, which will affect you. But we sit down wishing for money tonight so that they can decree laws and whatever that will make us, that will say, okay, yes, we prayed and we change it. Yes, we believe so much in prayer. Prayer is good. But beyond that, it is time for believers to arise and shine your light so that darkness can recede. I don't know whether I'm talking to somebody here. And there are several spheres of influence in life. The first sphere of influence is what I call religion, which is worship. Please write it down. I'm taking you somewhere. It may not be what you want me to say, but that's why I said I didn't come to preach. I came to deliver God's message. I know worship, which is the belief system, which is religion. And one of the things that is affecting that sphere of influence is what I call idolatry. And what is idolatry? A lot of people are not living godly lives. So that sphere of influence is being affected. The Bible says the time has come for the people that will worship the Lord to worship Him what? In spirit and in truth. So that sphere of influence is being affected. Listen to me. If the worship realm is not in the right perspective, heaven will not come down to help us. It won't come down to help us. Believers are not living in the life. We're talking about balance. And we get there. We're talking about balance. So God expects us in the area of religion, in the area of our belief system, to stand up and live as lights that will drive away darkness. We are supposed to influence, legislate, take charge, and take control of the environment by our godly lifestyle. That is how that sphere of influence can be in place. Now listen, a lot of religion, a lot of people that are in religion different, all manner of things are happening. Even believers are talking against themselves. The people are raising tight tissues, they are raising this, they are raising, so there is chaos. There is darkness. We are going to pray. But beyond that is, I want you to go and be the messenger of light. A messenger of light that will go and say, listen, Father, in this sphere of influence as a pastor, Lord, I'm going to do what I should do. And when we do all we do, I do, you do, you do, you do. Can you imagine the multiplication factor that is taking place in the land? That is how to maintain balance in this cooker. I didn't come to preach. I know you are not happy, but it's okay. Praise the Lord. Ask your neighbor and say, what kind of life are you living? Number two is the sphere of family. Thank God for Sister Vivian's testimony. Praise God. Now, go and check the family system. Believers inclusive, things are not right. Somebody was talking, say, our boys have been taken. I don't know what you're talking. Yeah? They're killing them. All right. Why are they killing them? Gangs. How did they enter there? If the family system was intact. Now, social worker came, said, don't spank your children. Okay, if we can't spank them, there must be another measure of control. So, how do you do it so that you don't lose them? Now, children are being lost. And the family system is in chaos. Am I talking to you here? Yeah. Divorce is on the increase. That is the lifestyle now. Every person, I can't take it. His room, his everything. So the family system has found what God wants is out of course. It's out of course. Why? Because no patience, no love, no selflessness, but selfishness. It's all about me. Me and I. And me alone. What is the language? I, me, and whatever. Me, myself, and I. That is all. Mothers are no longer sacrificial. Fathers have lost it. Children are living a life without direction. So the family is not in place. And God is telling us, rule in the world. How will you rule if the family is out of course? So what am I saying today? I'm challenging the people here to arise. Let's arise as soldiers and generals. And let's take charge of the family system. Let's bear the pain of suffering for the world. Every suffering is not forever. Am I talking to you here? And let us stand up and bear it. And change it because it is changeable. Now listen to me. You are to make the world to conform to your God. You are not to conform to your God. Don't copy them. Don't live their lifestyle because their lifestyle is not Paul says the Lord. Am I making sense to anybody? Come on, rise up and tell somebody, say it's time to build a new standard. I'm not hearing you. Hello. I'm not hearing you. I want people that will dominate these spheres of influence. Let pastors that will preach the truth without minding who is offended stand up, accept the religious system. Let mothers and fathers arise and preach righteousness no matter what is happening in their family. Raise up their children to fear the law. It doesn't matter what the law says. Do it according to the law, but get your own stand and enforce righteousness in the family system. Are you hearing me here? When the family is in chaos, who will believe your testimony? A lot of testimonies has been buried and has been lost because people don't have the patience to stand through and bear whatever it is they have to bear to make them be what God wants them to be. Am I making sense here? I know this is not what you expect, but this is what God said to you. So whatever is wrong with your family, go and be a light today. And tell them that, okay, I want to change. I'm a change agent to an assignment. I want to bring about control in this sphere of influence. Let's start it. Don't say others should start it. You start it first. Others will join you. Am I making sense here? So we have talked about the worship system, that is the religious system. We have talked about the family system. There's also the media system. Go to the news everywhere. Bad news, bad news, bad news everywhere. CNN on it, BBC on it, Al Jazeera on it. Everywhere is one bad news or the other. Ladies and gentlemen, when are we going to take charge and let the media waves be spread with the gospel of the Lord? That is taking charge in the media sphere. Are you hearing me here? Why is it that no money, no money, no money? No money to preach, no money to do this, no money to do this. Many of us, where God sent us to be, we don't go there because it is not convenient for us. But there are people here. As your elder with thunder, we will sponsor media evangelism that will make the world to hear the good news and not bad news. Listen, we can do it. We can do it. We need people to arise. I'm careful. There are so many information in my hand that I'm trying not to say it. I was being told of a major station that will censor anything about God. Anything about God. Anything about testimony of the doings of God. Or anything about any other person, they amplify it and magnify it. But when it comes to anything about the testimony of the Lord, they hold it like this. Why? Because there are not the right people. The people that should arise, they are sitting down thinking it is meant for some people. It's not meant for us. Lift up your right hand to heaven. I came to challenge you today. Let your amen thunder. The greatness inside of you that your world is supposed to enjoy. As you will shout amen today, I command it to come out of you. Listen, if you don't fight today, the generation of our children are in trouble. If you don't rise up to fitting into your office and fitting into your position and stop complaining and talking nonsense. Listen to me, people that want to affect the sense of influence, they don't gossip. It's not about stories. Listen, life has gone beyond telling stories. Life has gone beyond being like, what happened? What happened? Your husband beat you. No, that is where you are sitting. Listen, generations that is coming, we need to rescue them. Why? Because of the darkness of the world today. Come on, be, shine your light so that your children will not suffer tomorrow. The kingdom of this world, let it become the kingdom of our God. There are kingdoms that are fighting us. And you are putting your head down to let them fight you. You are agreeing with them because you are not sensitive in the spirit. You don't know what is happening today. You are sitting down there, all you are talking about is legs and hair and dress. Legs and hair and dress and things that should meet you because you are on assignment. That is not the focus. Men and women that are focused on affecting the different spheres of influence, those things are coming to join them. I don't think twice before I wear clothes. Because whatever I need will come. Do you know why? Because God knows that I am on your mark. Whatever He says, I do. He will provide. He will take away peace from somebody to give me what I need. Hello? Why? Because He knows that I am working tirelessly to ensure that the sphere of influence I belong to stands out. Hello? That is what we have assignment. That's why I answered Mary like that. It depends on your assignment that will make you to stand up and help us. Do you make up? Hello? If you're happy and you know you shall, amen.
Amen.
Can I pray a dangerous prayer for you? Will you say amen?
Yes.
Where you are, we fight you today.
Amen. Amen.
So you are not ready.
Amen.
The one that is ready will shout amen. Do you know the meaning of that? I'm sitting on this chair. I'm sitting on this story, man. I'm sitting on this chair. And I'm careless and insensitive and indifferent to what is around me. And I stay comfortable because I can eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And then because my children are going to school, listen to me. The more you stay complacent, the more
Your lifestyle is already getting a battle that will be bigger than you, waiting for you to love. I'm not cursing you. I'm telling you the truth. Because of what you refuse to do, there is a battle waiting for you to love. That's why I pray that prayer. That when you are seated, if you refuse to move, let it get tired and push you out. So that you will do whatever wants you to do. And I pray that prayer again. Every chair that you are sitting on, I command the fire to begin to burn you out. God, you understood me. God, you understood. It is not God is waiting for you. It's not you waiting for God. The miracle you need is when you stand up. Some answers will never be delivered until you stand up. The breakthrough you are crying out for, ladies and gentlemen, you are wasting time on an assignment. The day you rise up, ladies and gentlemen, you see God opening doors. We are so insensitive and careless because of the need of our life. Want, not need. I did a conference last week and a lady came to talk to her. And she said, we should identify I want from my need. Desires lost of the flesh, competition and strife. I want to show them that I can do like them. I can wear what they wear. It's killing us. And lives are dying. Souls are perishing. And our sphere of influence is empty because you have not aligned yourself to your purpose. There are some of you that are supposed to be in the media sphere who are supposed to sponsor good news such that the world will be hearing good news instead of bad news. Hello? There's no place and there is no bad news, but bad news should not overshadow good news. But the people that will be the whatever, the messengers of good news, they are nowhere to be found. They are nowhere to be found. So the one that want to propagate bad news, they have the free show. They have the free show. Let church be here. Let church do television. Let church do that. Where do we get the money from? You are failure. You are failing. That is how to get involved in different spheres of influence. May God help us.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
If you're happy and you know you shall amen.
Amen.
Me, myself, I myself, I'll be what did you call it? Another sphere of influence is what I call government and politics. And what is killing that side is corruption. Thank God for Nigeria. Out of pride and manipulation, a lot of people have lost it. So we need leaders that are humble. And leadership starts from your home. Humility is the key to leading. If you will be followable, you must be humble. Leadership is a factor of how can I follow you? Are you? I mean, listen to me. If you are not followable, I can't. Excuse me. I can't join myself with you. Humility is the key. Hello?
Hi.
Humility is the key. A servant lifestyle. Serving the people. And it starts from your house. It starts from the church. It starts from your school. It starts from everywhere. That is how leaders have been picked. One of my friends came to one of my conferences and began to talk. And when I finished preaching, she said, this is how you have been from when you were young. When you were in school, this is how the leadership trait has always been there. Because you see, so the lady said, I was shocked that this is what you are doing. Now, building the leadership culture in you, being humble and serving men, loving men to a fault, appreciating the grace of God upon their lives, celebrating them in their naughtiness, praising men, not castigating them over their weaknesses. What they don't have is not the issue. Celebrate what they have. That is the leadership trait. That is how to maintain balance in life. You want to correct people, you have not praised them. You want to celebrate, you want somebody to be somewhere and you have not been able to look at that good aspect of our life. You are killing people with your eyes, killing people with your mouth, killing people with your attitude. and then you are blaming people at the top. Look at them, they are corrupt. Corruption is in the heart, and it starts from individuals. Balance. As a road, I'm sorry. But I didn't pray for us. I hope so. Government is waiting, politics is waiting. Rise up and locate your place. Which sphere do you belong? The sphere of family? Can you change family lifestyle? Can you rise up and be passionate? Social workers should represent, I mean, they are supposed to occupy the family sphere. That is in terms of those that are fighting for child protection and all those. How did they do it? How did they administer? Yeah, in this country, you can't do like Nigeria. There is a way out. Everything cannot be that difficult. There is a way out. Which sphere of influence do you belong? You see, I read John chapter 4, Pastor Luna, and I saw all this sphere of influence that God came, Jesus came to address in that woman by the way. All these spheres of influence are there. Because God was addressing her by her prophecy. He was telling her what she should have become and what she settled for. And God came to deliver her so that there would be balance in her life. God came to deliver her from the passion of flesh. Came to deliver her from what she didn't lose that she thought she lost. That has made men to take advantage of her. Jesus was addressing every state of her life. I was telling her there is something in you that is bigger than what you are crying about for. And that is when I came to call out. You are supposed to stand up and be in the sphere of influence of religion to go and change the lives of men. And the day she realized it, the Bible said she dropped her pot and she went about, come and see, oh, come and see, oh, come and see. Evangelism started. She was an evangelist from that. But situations of life shut up her mouth. So she began to live an imbalanced life. Being filled by emotions, hey, I want a man. Will you shut up your mouth? Look at people that have gotten men. See where they got. When you get something that God did not give you, may God deliver us. Yeah. Marriage is right. So, but marry the man that God wants you to marry. Don't marry out of emotion. Don't marry out of age. Don't marry out of my friend said it. Excuse me. Right, sit down and wait on the Lord so that your destiny will not be wasted. Hello. Hallelujah. If you're happy with me, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm not hearing you shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There is a sphere of education, science, and technology where lies is taking charge. I mean, it's taking hold. The whole world is not just Africa that is out of course. Everywhere something is happening.
Yeah.
Everywhere something. Can you imagine in the US them taking a lot of things out of the education system? And people are waiting. Listen, the other side of religion, they plan ahead. We sit down and praying and wishing things to happen. The meaning of wish is that something that you have in your heart that may never happen.
Yeah.
It may never happen. You wish. You sit down there, you're wishing, and they are slapping you left and right because they are strategic. They remove our father's prayer from you. They remove so many things from US. In US. Not Nigeria. Leave Nigeria alone that allowed my malpractice. It's the order of the day in that place. Parents pay for their children to pass. That is how lies have entered into the education sector. Am I making sense to you here? Because order is not maintained. There is no balance. And believers are sitting down, folding their hands and praying. I wish. And he said, let them change the law. Who are those that will change the law? Are they the people that fears God? Are the people that fears God, are they the ones in authority? What happened to you? Why don't you wake up and locate something in you that will make God to announce you to your world? Who told you can't get there? Who told you cannot occupy strategic offices? Listen, carry your eyes from what you're crying for. Focus on destiny. Look at what God wants us to do in the health sector. Let's go and sit down and wake up and do what heaven has sent us to do. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I didn't come to preach, I came to deliver a message. Because God told me to come and tell you, I've been waiting for you. This is not where you should be. But you are believing yourself. Because you don't believe in what your God can do. Amen.
Amen.
If you're happy with me, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay, rise up, go and tell every person, say, I'm a leader.
Hallelujah.
Come on, go and tell everybody, say, I'm a leader. Go and shout it to them. As I'm preaching, I want you to look at yourself. Which fear do you belong to? Which fear of evil? Which fear of evil? You just sit down there breaking chair every day with complaint. Complain and murmur. They didn't do this, they did this. This is what they did. No, life has left that level. Life has left that level. The women of today, they are no longer gossiping. The real women. Are you hearing what I'm saying? They don't have time to gossip. No. The real women of today don't say, what did your husband buy for you yesterday? Your husband. What is? No. Ladies and gentlemen, we have left that stage. We have left the association of itchy-minded people. We have left the association of men and women that are looking for sales in different sports. Because we don't have the time. Time is too precious to be wasted. Are you hearing what I'm saying here?
Yeah.
We are busy. We are business conscious. We know we don't have forever. So we are on our mark. Looking at the sphere of influence we belong to and want to register our influence. We want to make impact. We want to let the world know that there is a God that can save. There is a God that can bring order upon the society. We want to let the world know that we were created to reign and to rule. When you know who you are, they won't tell you who you are not.
That's right.
Economy, commerce, and business. That is another one. Any of you, go and do business. You hit all the money because you remove God out of your business. You will not pay tax. You will not do anything. You are just doing it. You are just doing it and eating everything. The love of money has made you so greedy. And you don't spend your money in God's purpose. You spend it anyhow. And when I have that, I can do anything I like. Listen, greatness is studious. Greatness is wise. Greatness. Hello?
Yes,
understand what you call time and season. And you know what they call delayed gratification. I was being told of a man that is doing one business, entrepreneur, whatever. It was Pastor Ms. Aliyah that was telling me how much he's making at 26 years old. How the boy is making is a multi-millionaire in pounds. He's 26 years old. And then he now decided he's an entrepreneur. He's doing some strange things. He now decided that he wants to be teaching people, Christians, how to be in charge financially. He's introducing them into this business that is taking charge in the business sphere. Because you want to reproduce so many of him so that there will be many multi-millionaires. No, he's not greedy, he's not selfish. Because he knows that gospel needs money. He needs to supervise many Christians to become millionaires. That is how to be ready. Are you hearing me here? Not that go and do, you don't do. You don't do this, you don't. Why? Because you are so indifferent. Nobody did anything. You sit down there, they will shake you. You remain unshaken. And you are giving problem every day. Listen, I've discovered that it's when you don't have something to do that you talk about. Poor people talk too much. Rich people, they are planning. So when I'm too busy planning, I don't have time to talk story. Look at Joke married yesterday. Why did she do church wedding? She has not done church wedding. Look at them. So we look for all manner of nonsense news to spread because you don't have assignment. You have no job. Hello? You have no job. You are not busy. You are not ready to move forward in life. That's why you can. And the sphere of influence is still there. You think that greatness is by speaking English? Come to Nigeria and see people breaking English. And beyond that, come to Nigeria. People that have not reached with the Lamb Mohammed International Airport. Yeah. When they speak English, they will win you. My mind will put you and will measure you. They will score more than you. Yeah. They have not traveled at all. Their quick English is intact.
Yeah.
When they talk like this, you will wonder, maybe they born there. And they don't know Lagos. Some of them don't know Lagos.
Yeah.
They don't know Lagos. Because it's not quick English that we use to measure greatness. What we use to measure be relevant and productive in your sphere of influence. Stop looking at men. Stop looking at what people don't do. Now, give yourself a task. This is what I want to achieve before August. It is possible. Am I making sense?
Yes.
I don't know whether I'm preaching to anybody. This is strange. I know you want me to say, come out, shut down, come down, shut down, shut down. I have done no clothes for years. Believers are getting poorer. Because they are not obedient. They don't follow instruction. You give us a day, we pray from morning to night. We were to weary our soul. Because you refuse to obey instruction. You stay there. All you are doing is just looking for what is wrong, who to break down, who to remove the shoe, who to fight, who to Great people don't fight. They have no time to fight. But all you are looking for is how to eat two heads together and cause commotion and confusion. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
They said they brought them. You did not eat it. I gathered a set of people and said, listen, I want to kick you into your millions. They said, how will you keep us? I said, see that. The one that is not obeying me, I'm deleting you. Get out from my side. Get out from my side. Listen, since the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God, suffer the violence. The violence do what? They take you out. Come and tell your neighbor, say, stop sitting down. I'm not hearing you. Shout it better. Shout it better. Shout it better. If you are happy with me, put your hands together and celebrate you. You are not happy, but it's okay. I know you are not unhappy. Praise the Lord. But I didn't come to preach, I came to deliver God's message. That's why I'm talking the way I'm talking. God, we are waiting for you. God is waiting for you. Don't blame me. Some of you will die finished, and your grave will swallow your riches. Because you carried it back, you didn't drop it on the earth. And throughout your life, you suffered. Hello? Management is not greatness. Survival is not greatness. Are you hearing me here? I survive. I'm fine. I'm using the repair. I'm using the wheel is the extra. If I say I need £5,000 today, can you give me? Even if I tell you £500, will you not turn your head to the other side? That shows you are not great. Great people, if I ask for £5,000, they say, Mama, okay, give me some time. 3 days, I will produce it. That is great person. That is great person. That is a great person. I don't measure greatness by just money. I measure greatness by the ability to rise up to the occasion. I won't ask him for £5,000 to go and buy shoe. I will ask him for £5,000 because of assignment. And you will see the assignment with your hands. Are you hearing what I'm saying there? What can you boast of? Okay, let me ask you, what is your achievement between last year and this year? What did you do? We are talking about balance. I don't know whether I'm preaching balance, but I'm preaching God's message at the same time. So if it is not balanced, I'll remove it. But hear my message. I'm not fighting anybody, but I'm tired of Christians that are sitting down poor. Living in frustration. Being an answer to the world. You have nothing to show. The world is tired of telling us stories. We want action.
Amen.
What is your achievement? Mary, what have you achieved between last year and this year? Be not giving back to children. Be not getting married. I didn't marry. I got married. Mama, I got married in December. Praise God. After marriage, marriage is a stage in life. And we all get married, those of you that have not. But beyond that, what is your fruit? Where is your fruit? That is what we need to focus on. What's your achievement? How many people have you helped between last year and this year? has your money affected? How many people did your prayer deliver from sickness and oppression? How many people can you boast of and testify of your life between last year and this year? Is it the same story you keep telling us every day? You, at this stage of your life, all of you, I know some of you, just few people, I don't know your faces here. Not many of you here, you should be praying for people by now. You should be in charge by now. You're not supposed to be giving headache to anybody. Say, mama, Pastor, you didn't. You are the one that we should be asking. That, okay, Mary, you didn't do this. Whatever. Pastor, Bala, you didn't do this. If you are happy, honey, you know, you shall be happy. Amen. That is a blessing. Say, come on, be happy with mama. Don't let the Holy Ghost love you. You are not happy with me? You will sleep tonight. But you not see an angel that is pursuing you. So tell him or ask him, come and be happy. Now ask her, what are you going to do between now and August? It is good to make it a short term plan, separating it from a long term plan. Ladies, are you here? Please give me your attention, please.
Oh, wow.
I'm here for business. Because by the time I come back, I don't know whether I'm coming back next year. Because my message today may not make you want me to come back next year. Praise the Lord. If you're happy, shout hallelujah. By the time I come back, whichever time I come back, what will be the produce? What will you show me that you have produced? Short time plan. Get your paper. Let's do workshop. Give yourself when is what? A goal. Give yourself an assignment between now and August. This is May, June, July, August. 3 months plan. Make a 3 months plan tonight. That is how to progress. Don't leave it in the cloud. Mama came to preach like this. Mama lashed us. Mama did this. And that is the end. That is the end. What is your, what will be your plan, Pastor Christian, between now and August? What will you show me that you have achieved? If by the end of August there is no achievement, there should be a process and a progress. Our God is not a static God. We are too young to waste our life. Listen, time is going. You will wake up suddenly and discover we are 50. We never thought we would be 50 so soon. Am I right? You are 25. Okay, deceive yourself. Am I preaching here? That is the same way you will suddenly wake up and discover that you are 50. Then you say, what have I achieved? Excuse me, what have I achieved? Well, I don't know. Then you carry your paper. You can't see anything. And the age is going. I was writing throughout since I came. And one of the things I wrote down is, can your age, can your result measure with your age?
Wow.
How old are you? Hello? That is balance in life. How old are you? Now, if we see the results of your life now, do they match? Do they match with your age? I came as a voice tonight. I came to shake you from your place. That's why the Bible says, arise from your depression and your frustration. Those nonsense things you are thinking about. Life is bigger than this, your four corner that you put yourself. Get out from your box. Let all this nonsense that you put on your head drop. Locate assignment. Stay in your assignment and let your word celebrate you. Celebration will never come until you align yourself with your purpose. Why are you on earth? If you have not discovered it, these 3 months is an opportunity for you. Nobody is even like, there's nobody that is thinking like I'm thinking. Some are laughing and smiling at the back. So which means I'm wasting my time. No. But I believe, when I'm like this, listen, that means that. But I know that for me to speak this message, there are people that by August, I will be in the country in September. I want to hear your news. You must challenge yourself, okay? That my life must change in the next 3 months. Now, everybody, it is your duty to give yourself that challenge. Every day you wake up, you must challenge yourself that my life must be better today than what it was yesterday. That is how to move forward. As long as you're comfortable with the same lifestyle of yesterday, and you wake up and you tolerate it again, you wake up, you dust your hand, you go to party, you waiting for Saturday party and all those things, you jump up and down, you do everything you want, and you finish the party went, and you are still the same. You are still the same. And the spheres of influence are being governed by unbelievers. They are legislating our future. The future of our children in the hands of unbelievers. Christians sit down. Business, they are not relevant. Leadership, they are not there. Family, their family is in pieces. Hello? Education, we can't feel your impact. Are you getting what I'm saying? Believers stay there. Unbelievers are taking the sugar. And unbelievers will decide the future of your children. And anything they legislate that is accepted, it becomes a law. And then you begin to cry. And then you will not be doing prayer meeting. All night prayer conference. Father, we change. We unseat. We unseat. What were you looking when they sat here?
Wow.
Why don't you affect the day before they got there?
Yes.
Hello? Yeah. Why is it not a believer that is sitting there? I don't know whether I'm making sense.
Yeah.
I don't know whether I'm making sense. Two more scriptures and I leave this place. Because I know it's not a good message today. Ephesians chapter 6. I want to show you Ephesians chapter 6. The same scripture that I've been reading from verse 10, which many of us can quote on the head, to put an emphasis on what we are dealing with now. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord. In the power of his might. He didn't say be strong in your knowledge. He didn't say be strong on your tongues. He said be strong in the Lord. You cannot be strong in the Lord if you don't know the Lord.
Yes.
It's not possible.
Yes, ma'am.
So the knowledge of God makes you to know, to have a knowledge of your mandate in life. When you know God, you know what he sent you to do.
Hallelujah.
If you don't know him, you can't know what he has written about you. Jesus was able to come and stand in his office because he knew his assignment even before he was created. I know why I came. When Paul wanted to dwell on the little achievement, he spoke to himself, I'm not rich there. He said, no, forgetting the things of yesterday. He said, I have not thing or whatever. I press forward. Why? Because there was then a purpose that was not achieved. You understood this. Be strong. Now, your strength is a function of your knowledge. Your strength is a function of what you know. What you don't know cannot help you. God is telling us today, he said, put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to withstand against the wiles of the devil. Move on quickly. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood. Listen, behind the scene is a hand. Whatever is wrong with you, there's a control. We are dealing with flesh. We are not dealing with flesh and blood. We are dealing with principalities.
Wow.
We are dealing. When people sit in offices and legislate and make rules and make law, there are principalities behind them.
Yeah.
So you just think that it is normal. But you are sitting down, folding your hand, thinking that that thing is for others. It's not for you. You don't know that you are part of the happening class. You are part of those that should make things to happen. You sit down, you fold your hand, you are fighting, you are quarreling, you are keeping at this, you are doing this, you are doing that, and time is going, and principalities are having the show.
Mm.
against powers, rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Can I pray for you now? As your amen with honor, I'm not finished. I'm not finished. Leave it on my strength. I want your amen with honor. Every principality behind your trouble that is not making you to align with God's purpose in your life. If your amen with honor, I command them to be silent. See how they shout amen. When I've been talking to somebody, they don't reply like that. So your own is just to fight with them. But you don't know that you have to fight yourself. Are you getting what I'm saying here? Yeah? I purposely did that and I saw that that is what I expected. That's what I expected. We will glorify the devil too much. Hello? I understand. You don't need to tell me when it comes to deliverance, when it comes to demons and all those things. Yes. It's my field. But beyond that, is dealing with yourself. Telling yourself, get up, Choke. Get up, Ellie. Get up. Get up. What are your names again? I've forgotten all your names. It's because I'm preaching that I forgot all your names. Get up. Get up from lukewarmness. Get up. Get up. Get up from what this cell, whatever. Go and see what you should use Facebook to do properly. Instagram. Go and see what you should use it to do properly. Another, see me, I just finished eating the Chinese salad. You can't even say, come on, tell me, come on, get up! Do something of purpose, something of important things, not something of truthless things. You do like a village, yourself and tell yourself the devil is not more powerful than you. All power in heaven and earth has been given unto you. There is power, power past power. But do you know why the devil can pitch his tent on whatever on our head? Because they're not getting up. They're snapping picture about. Posting on everything. Posting. I'm not against posting, but post serious things. Yeah. Serious minded. I want to read about the souls that you love God converted. Yeah. I want to read. Listen, I started going to the prophets. You all know that I have a project, the Sever Project. I started going to the prophets in January, February. And I went to the prophet myself. People were shocked. I said, yes, this is assignment, this is purpose. You're not bigger than the assignment that God gave you.
Yeah.
I went there with my team. We preached. We did program. 30 of prostitutes came. 15 or 16 of them gave their lives to Christ. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Yeah. Post that. Don't call them prostitutes. I've given them a name. Making a lady honorable. That is the project. 16 of them gave their lives. Two of them develop boldness and say, Mama, we are not staying in the brotherly. We are housing them now and taking care of their need. They are going to start going for their training on Monday. Every of their need and responsibility on our head. That is what I want you to post. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, Mama.
Not that you are eating food and you are calling enemies upon your head. You bought a new dress of £500. You post it. They are shaking out. People are doing it. You can. But let me see. When you post nonsense, let me see 10 cents you are posting before I see one nonsense. Because to you, it's not nonsense. To me, it's me counting it as nonsense because destiny differs, understanding differs. Can I pray for you again? Every principality that is making your head, choosing it to beat drum, making you to be ignorant of purpose, making you not to be daring, to be indifferent to your assignment. As your anger will turn around, I command them to be silent. Yeah. It is spiritual wickedness that is not making you to sit up to your assignment. Spiritual wickedness. It makes you to be wasting your time before you know it. You have grown bold. You ask yourself questions, your mates have overtaken you. Because your mate has sense. When we pray prayer that your mate will not overtake you, listen, mates that have sense will overtake you. When we pray such prayers, so don't deceive yourself. Say, Mama has prayed, my mate will not overtake me. If you are ignorant and indifferent, sit down there, mate will pass you. They will pass you. That is when your mate will gather and you will go ahead. Say, excuse me. What I'm wearing is not good. What I'm doing is, excuse me, come on.
No.
Give me the next verse. Wherefore, take unto you. Is this the next verse?
Yeah.
The whole arm of God. I may be able to withstand the evil day. Having done all, do what?
Stand.
Okay, let's see what he said we should stand. Stand therefore, having your loins that about the truth. Truth is not lie. You get the truth from the scriptures. Guide your loins with the truth. What is the meaning of that? Understand whatever said to you, truth about your life. You are not an assignment. You are not on this side of eternity to waste your days. What is the truth about your life? Guide your loins with truth. Above marriage does not mean that I am not married. It is the truth. Marriage is coming. Guide your loins with truth. Understand. I'm sick. They say I'm sick. Okay. Sickness is a platform for God to do a miracle. Am I making sense here? That is the truth. Sickness is not supposed to kill me. It's supposed. It's just bringing the glory of the Lord out. Understand this. I've not done this. I've not done this. Yes. It has not happened. But it's going to happen. That is the truth. Because the expectations of the righteous can never be controlled. That is the truth. Am I blessing you tonight?
Yeah.
Guard yourself with the truth, understanding of who heaven called you to be. Stop letting them make you, because they stop it and they stop it and they say, I do agree. And you stay there crying. Then number two. Put on the breastplate of righteousness. You know the meaning of that? That is how to deal with spiritual wickedness. Live right. Live right. That is what has already happened. Don't be a Pharisee. Don't pretend. Don't deceive men. Live right. These are the factors that makes you to be balanced in life, that makes you to stand and face and challenge wickedness. Hallelujah. Put on the breastplate. Let it be what we see in you. Breastplate. You put breastplate. What is breastplate? Is it not here? Yeah. So that is what they see. Your right living. Right living. Not announcing. I am a Christian, no. As you appear, the breastplate is shown right to me. We can see it by their fruit, they shall know. You don't need to tell us. You don't need to announce to me you are a Christian. Let me see your character. I know. Don't tell me I prophesied yesterday. So what? That will be prophesied. Breastplate. Then what next? What next? And your feet showed with the preparation of the gospel of the what's the meaning of that? Do you know you are sleeping? What's the meaning of that? Preach the gospel.
Amen.
The great commission still stands going into the world. That's what they've been telling you since yesterday. Guard your feet with the gospel of peace. Do you know the meaning of that? Anywhere you are going, as a focus, I am a gospel representative. My life must minister. In the shop, it must minister. I'm buying something, it must minister. Are you hearing me? I'm cooking, it must minister. I'm with my children, it must minister. I have this and that.
Amen.
They showed something. I don't know whether you people saw it on Facebook or whatever. Of a man and a woman that called the doctor to see them. And they were teaching her Bible. And they said, look, my dear, a sinner, did you go to hellfire? Same is cookies. And they said, why you tell lie? You go on, it's hellfire. Thank you, bless daddy. The daddy was talking. Said, daddy, you mean, when we lie, we're going to hellfire. The mother said, ah, my daughter, hellfire, me, liar. They're going to hellfire. The girl started crying. She just busted into the house, stop there. Just busted into tears. The father said, ah, my dear, what happened? The mother said, she has a confession to make. I am sure. The girl said, Mom, Daddy, liars, they're going to hellfire.
Mommy is going to hellfire.
By the time they showed the picture of how the woman was living at night, of how the life she was, the way she was living before the girl. So the girl busted into tears, say, ah, mommy, hellfire. By the time they showed it, the girl told the father, the mother broke down and began to cry. God's full of peace. What is the next thing? Above all, taking the shield, your belief system. I believe my religion. I believe lips. I believe that what he has said is going to come to pass. The shield of faith. Then he finished, with which you will quench the fiery darts of the wicked. Then what they did? And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. These are the factors that makes you to be balanced in life. Go and affect your sphere of influence with these factors from Genesis, I mean from Ephesians 6, I think from verse 14, all those things were written. Gospel of peace, truth, breastplate of righteousness, faith, the word of God. If you practice it, you will discover the revelation of your life. If you practice it, you will see your influence being made. God has called us to make it free. Stop giving excuses. Lord asked me to tell you in this house that it is time to go forward.
Amen.
And that's where I'm ending my message. In Exodus chapter 14, they taught me, why are you crying? Stretch for the Lord. Tell the people it is time to go forward. God asked me to tell you now that the hour has come for us to wake up. Wake up from whatever has happened in the past and go forward. God affect your sphere of influence. Sister Fola, you are in health. Are you not a nurse? Go and affect the health sector. Let them know that a believer is here. Minister like never before. I know that here you can't pray, you can't do something. But then, let your light so shine. People know how they do it. Dr. Maduka has told me one day that it's difficult sometimes to do some things in the health sector, but there is a way you can get it done.
Yes.
There is a way. God teaches you and makes you to know a way to do it. Don't let the system frustrate the grace of God in the inside of you. You are to shine out in darkness. Darkness will continue. But God is depending upon you to be the light that will shine, that will take away the resources of this earth from the unbelievers, that will make you listen. He wants to transfer it. Go and check your value. That the house of the wicked, the riches there shall be overthrown, and it shall be given to the tabernacles of the righteous. Maybe God wants to do it, but he has not seen a prepared heart. A heart that is ready to take charge in his or her sphere of influence. You are crying, my leg is telling me, I don't have this, I don't have this, I don't have this. God is telling you, I'm waiting for you. What you are crying over, it doesn't take me one word. The whole thing disappears. But you are wasting time by sitting down there, not doing what I ask. And ladies, what God told me is this: if you keep wasting time, the generation of your children is in trouble. Rise to your feet. No, you don't need to clap because I'm not just forcing yourself to clap. But I'm so excited because I've been so watching. I've been so burdened because I know what God said me to do is too heavy. But I know those that understand that I don't talk just anyhow. I hope you will learn with it. Mr. Fala, there is a next level for you.
Ah, yeah.
There's a next level. There's a grace that I saw flowing over you for an assignment that is given you. You have been dilly-dallying on it, but God said, go and do it. Am I right? There's something He has given you to do. Can you step out here? And let me just stretch my hands over you. Beloved, there is an assignment that is waiting. Stretch your hands towards me. No, want somebody by your side. Don't somebody by your side. And let's pray together. Now, whatever is stopping you, I command you to be lifted up.
Amen.
Okay, now can we pray that prayer? Hold your neighbor. 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. And let's pray. Say with me. Say, Father, whatsoever is holding my sister down, I command you to be lifted. Shout it again. Say, Father, whatsoever is holding her down, I command you to be lifted. Shout it again. Say, Father, whatsoever is holding her down, I command you to be lifted. Open your mouth and make your prayer. God is waiting for us. God is waiting. God is waiting.
Come down.
God is waiting. The world is waiting. Self to self by the services of God.